This is a program that discusses issues of faith for people looking for answers. This is Viewpoint with Bob Placey.
Are Christian values being intentionally left out of motion pictures and television? And if so, how do we get it back in? Phil Cook's a filmmaker, media consultant, and author of this book, The Way Back, How Christians Blew Our Credibility and How We Get It Back. He joins us today from Burbank, California. And Phil, you've been out in Hollywood or Burbank for a couple years, right?
Yeah, quite a long time.
And has Hollywood changed in its view of what Christianity is and its view of, I guess, the church in general over that time?
There's no question. I think I've been here since 91, and actually I was coming here for a number of years before that. I think that Hollywood has changed. In many ways, the whole culture's changed today. And one of the things I would be clear about is I don't think Hollywood is really anti-Christian. I think many of us have this, you know, think this myth that Hollywood is virulently anti-Christian, and it's really not. It's just made up of people who are in a business. I don't think Hollywood is more anti-Christian than plumbers or attorneys or other groups. They're just people that didn't grow up in the church for the most part, that are quite secular, as we see in many other areas of our culture, and they really don't understand what Christianity is all about.
Yeah.
So what we need are more Christians, I think, who feel called to come out here, stop looking at Hollywood as the enemy and start looking at Hollywood as a mission field. And we need media missionaries, if you will, who would be willing to come to Hollywood, work from the inside to start changing the industry. I think that would be the most effective thing we could possibly do.
Would the quality still be there?
Yeah, I think quality matters. Quality, you know, that's one thing we've learned over the years. You know, Christians have started making movies that are going to the box office, that are going to theaters. And in the early days, I was encouraging filmmakers to make better quality films because no matter how great the story, if the movie's shot terribly, nobody wants to watch. So quality does matter. But I think at the same time, we have to start engaging the industry because, you know what, you may hate Hollywood, but they sure know how to produce and market movies and television programs. And so it's not that we want to view them as the enemy so much, but we want to get in there and leverage what their ability that, you know, they're able to do and get our message inside some of those films. And there are many people right now that are doing a great job of it.
Well, it is an industry and they're there to make money. And if Christian films or films that really lifted up the Christian lifestyle were making money at the box office, Hollywood's not going to turn that down, are they?
That's exactly right. You know, it's interesting that at the turn of the last century, in the beginning of the 1900s, the church made more movies than Hollywood did. The church was actively, in the early days of the movies, the church was actively involved in movie making. But then the church started to slowly pull back in the 20s, the 30s, the 40s. And of course, if there's a void, something else is going to fill it. And so we found ourselves in the 70s and 80s with an industry that was almost entirely secular. Then when Mel Gibson created the movie, The Passion of the Christ, and it did so spectacularly well internationally, we realized that Hollywood saw that, wow, there are people that take their faith seriously and really want to see films that take their faith seriously. So Hollywood's been on a slow journey trying to understand who this audience is, how to reach them with products. Sometimes they fail, sometimes they succeed, but I think it's moving in a good direction.
Well, there used to be, you mentioned the church making movies and Christians making movies. There used to be a board of basically they were going to look at movies and decide whether or not they were even viewable or not. That whole board has disappeared now.
Yeah, it was called the Hays Code. It started. Mm-hmm. It was actually a moral code of what you could do. You couldn't smoke in movies. You couldn't do all kind of things.
You had to have twin beds and things like that.
Yeah, there you go.
I love Lucy. Had twin
Desi
beds.
Lucy Arnaz, you know, in the Lucille Ball show. They had separate beds when they were married. And so we see that that's gone away. And now it's much, you know, a lot more freedom out there for filmmakers. It also means you can go in some, you know, dark directions as well.
Right.
So I think we're seeing Christians that are producers, that are studio executives, that are writers, that are stepping up and at a very high level in the industry in Hollywood. So the bottom line is I would tell people watching the program right now is stop criticizing Hollywood and start praying for Hollywood. Think of it as a mission field for real and really start praying for the industry and hopefully move them in a direction to where they would become Christians, because that would the influence of Hollywood. I mean, Hollywood still has the greatest influence in the world of anything out there. So if we could shift that, it would be remarkable.
Yeah, we talk about Hollywood as just push the borders. I mean, push the boundaries of what's allowable on television and in movies. I mean, you couldn't use certain words after 8 o'clock, before 8 o'clock, things like that.
Right.
Do we want to bring the boundaries back in, or do we just want to bring Christian culture into Hollywood and hope there's more of that?
I don't necessarily want to bring the boundaries back. I mean, obviously, there were many good things about it, but it's, at the same time, they restricted some very talented people, mm-hmm. and you never know who's going to be in control of the rules. It's like free speech. I would rather, you know, the only way to solve bad speech is to create more good speech. It's not to restrict people, because whoever's in charge starts restricting things. So the list I don't think is necessary, or the Hays Code type approach. I think it's better to raise up a generation of young filmmakers who are Christians, who feel a real call in their life to go out and change the industry. And, you know, so very often we tend to help a young ministry student or a missionary. We tend to offer them a free room in our home or help pay some of their expenses. What about finding a filmmaker in your church or your neighborhood, a young person who feels called to go into the industry and work? Maybe you could help them with their expenses or training or going to film school. That would be a remarkable thing in helping make an impact here in Hollywood.
Well, we've seen Hollywood produce films like Noah and things like that, and Christians want to boycott it. They don't want to go. It's not biblically correct. Is that what we still need to do with films like that?
Well, Hollywood's going to make mistakes. Obviously, Noah wasn't the biblical story of Noah. In fact, I was one of the people that negotiated with the studio to create a disclaimer at the front of the movie that just reminded people this was not the biblical story of Noah. Mm-hmm. But in spite of all that, I encourage Christians to go to the film, take a non-believing friend, mm-hmm. and after it's over, go to a coffee shop and tell them the real story. Use it as kind of a doorway to help people understand what the real story is. And so I just think that even with movies that miss the mark, there's often still an opportunity for evangelism. And so Hollywood's trying. I think I'd rather support their efforts and try to move them in a positive direction than constantly be criticizing them, because if we continue that approach, they're just going to pull back and they're not going to do it at all. So I think, you know, praying for the industry, praying for Hollywood is a powerful, powerful thing, because as we all know, prayer really does change things.
What kind of reaction did you get when you negotiated that disclaimer at the front of the movie?
The studio realized. I mean, I've been here in Hollywood for a long time, and we have enough credibility with the industry that we often get called into situations where they want advice about how to reach the Christian mm-hmm. audience. And so that was a situation where they wanted to see. We actually did a screening of the movie at the National Religious Broadcasters Conference, and we got input from them. And so we were able to sit down with the studio leaders and say, look, we don't want to offend, you know, whatever you do, you don't want to offend Christians, because they're a huge segment of the box office. So they were very willing to put a disclaimer on the front of the movie just to let people know it's not the biblical story. It's more like a science fiction story. And it worked really well. And I got criticized more from Christians for even being involved with it than I did from people in the studio. So it's, you know, Christians are still working all that out, figuring out how do we deal with this kind of stuff. And I'm just thrilled that God's put us in a position here in Hollywood to help people navigate that industry.
Well, the whole area of media production, I mean, it's wider now than it's ever been, digital and all types of streaming, things like that. What kind of hope you have for the future as far as Christians coming into the production of media?
We have a generation of kids today that are making movies on their iPhones. Mm-hmm. So, you know what? I think people younger and younger are being fluent with visual media. And so whether it's web, social media, TV, films, I feel really good about the future. There's a lot of issues to be concerned about. You know, there's a dark side to social media. There's a dark side to a lot of different media mm-hmm. platforms. But I would love to see Christians become more literate in media, understand the power of television and film and social media. And I think that's the greatest way to combat it. Help teach your children, train them how to use media effectively, how to be responsible with an iPhone, with social media, those things. I believe ultimately that's the answer that we need in order to move forward.
All right. It's not gone away. We need to know how to use it in ways that are going to be positive.
Exactly right. It is not going away. And fortunately, we have people like the YouVersion Bible app who are making the Bible available in multiple translations in hundreds and thousands of languages. Just a tap on an iPhone. So there are people out there innovating, doing some remarkable things, and I'm thrilled about the future.
If you'd like more information about Jesus Christ or how to connect to a local church, go to our website or Facebook page. We have a lot more resources there that we can connect you with. Plus, I'd like to hear from you.